That's
when you probably need to see them, isn't it? Well, that's it. I mean, that does say the fuse of arguing now. This is just a bit of an iceberg.
You're only
going to
get more stressed as well if you go over there and you don't like it.
It's hard because I love her. I don't want her to go. I'd love it. Do you know something? It's not about that. I would probably be up for going all up for it and excited about going if I'd been living with Kirsty for 5 years.
Aye.
And I knew that there was a strong bond. There's not going to be any arguments or fights. Or, everybody has arguments, but I mean, this is like getting her mum involved and all that. It's,
you need to sit there and tell her that. You need to say, listen, I'm not happy with your mum getting involved. I'm not happy with you going up there sitting with my mum bitching about my dad. And that's my mum, that's my dad. They've got their issues. It's going to fuck all the day with you. It's going to fuck all the day with you.
She goes, I don't go up bitching with your dad. It's your mum that does that.
Don't, well, don't, just don't go.
Exactly.
She can't go up there without bitching with your dad. Then there's no need for her to be there.
That's it, that's what
just
I say.
Just say, if you love me, that's one thing you can say for me.
How are you going to spend that? Because that right. Entire crews will play on half. They're up in a bit. Heading straight towards that garage. Couldn't be easier. Just pop in your postcode and trade your after. This one right here.
Park in the driveway.
In fact, it's so easy, your nan could do it with one hand tied behind her back while balanced on top of a motorcycle display table.
Oh, she's
nice to get her out of the home for the day.
Yeah, she's
going to
be a
bit
of a
bitch. Nice to get her out of the home for the day. Easy to use. Just one of the things that made TrustedTrader.com the UK's trusted online trade directory.
The Debenhams final summer clearance. Up to 70% off.
What is that? The engine
turned
itself back on.
Like, it's open the door?
Aye.
Oh, is it all controlled to that?
Aye.
I didn't realise that.
If, see, if you open the door, like you turn the car off and open the door and leave the key in, it goes beep, 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 beep. Listen. I'll wait to. That's not working. It's because I've just waited to start it, but normally it goes beep, 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 beep.
Yeah?
It's small, I struggled to get rid of
that. The toilet's in there.
Where?
That door there.
Okay.
Hi.
That's where
I'm going.
Oh, what's been going on,
what's
been going on?
Hello.
Hi, Reggie. Starving.
Oh, I'm at the dinner stage to see some evangelist at Melvin
Mays
Church.
Oh, are
they?
Just
again.
So.
I was too tired. So.
Granny was in the hospital this morning.
I know. I heard.
Are
you going to McDonald's, did you say? What's the lights off in here?
What they off for?
Yeah,
I remember using another one at this time.
Yeah, you do mind when it's bright outside.
It's so dark.
It's
getting
dark. What's happening
over there in that house?
They must be selling it.
Are they?
Aye,
it's amazing. I've just seen it. Seen it up last night.
Mm-hmm.
What's
happening?
Oh, just... I don't know.
They're
wearing their mum's.
I see.
Bags a little. Cats and all.
Cats?
No, the cats are still in the house. But,
she's like a wee lassie who's in a tantrum. Can you get her?
This is Lizanne. This is the one I got Jake over.
Oh, don't blame me. It's roasting in here.
I know. It looks the way I like it.
This is the one that gave me the...
Take.
The peak.
Jake was alright. You should have done that to him, nobody else.
I know, but Jake is lovely wee dog.
I miss him.
I bet you miss him, Paul. Lovely wee dog, wouldn't you, David?
It just something like insane.
You
went there if you'd have lived up there, you'd have been insane. You're far better off
without dogs and cats and all these
things. You've got other problems to worry about than cats and dogs. You don't need that hanging out of your head.
No, you weren't in the day to watch the wee thing, Paul. It'd have been better a man that did, was it retired.
Yeah.
You'd take him out of all and looked after him as if he was a wee child.
I know, I know. You can't sit down. How'd you turn it on? Up over the
pump? We were sitting here, this door was opening, there was a window open, and the wind was blowing through. And I said, see, it's all fucking cold here. I was sitting watching the daily. So I thought, put my fire on, but if you turn them on, it's fine.
The light not turn on?
Yeah.
Well, you need to turn them on, probably. Don't turn them on automatically.
That one does.
I was sitting here myself there.
That's what I tell you, my
that was my other room, playing his guitar. So I'm only sitting here watching the telly myself.
I thought Papa would have been here.
I don't need to do it.
The
light's on.
The church thing,
maybe it's for Livingston down at the...
No.
When did this all start? Last night?
Last night, aye.
Well, what happened? She come and pick you up at work?
No, she says, can you... Can you...
Did you walk?
I walked it, aye.
And she's sitting there with a...
Yeah, but she says you don't mind walking. I says I didn't mind walking. I honestly didn't. I went, aye, sure, I'll go up. I was actually looking forward to just kind of sitting and... But then... It got on a bit. I don't know, and then... things started going on about you, aye. I was sitting there listening to it.
That's
but when, like... That thing came up, like... The fact that you come over here for dinner. It's like a 50-year-old going around to his boys for dinner.
Imagine that coming up.
Do you know what I mean?
It's like, what the hell's it got to do with anybody else? What are you doing? You're like...
I
come in at lunchtime.
Because
I'm in work out the street. And I come in at lunchtime, and I get a bite to eat and I go back to my work.
And that was
but then you could pull her by saying, well, the minute anything goes wrong, you run to your mum and dad, you know?
I said that.
Well, my mum came up the stairs like a raging bull today. What are you playing at? Are you going to Ailerman? Are you not going to Ailerman? That's what I says to her. I said, this has nothing to do with Ailerman. This wee silly wee argument thing has nothing to do with the Ailerman. I says, you go down to your daughter and you tell her. What's it to do with?
But first thing, whether you want to go or not, it's got nothing to do with her mum.
I know, the first thing, it came in, she's like, I seen him crawling upstairs like a snake. Because I went up the stairs as soon as they came into the door. But I was only going up the stairs to just stay at a road. Because I wanted to just sit in the room. I didn't want any bother. My mum comes up the stairs. And the first thing that came out of her mouth was, did he hit you? That's what she said.
Paul, shut the door.
I did, I shut the door.
No, I mean, tell her it's... Because this, what you're getting now, is only just, if this is over something so trivial, wait till something big comes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And she can't handle anything, she's away with it.
But so what I've heard of her, what she done the day, I think she's a bit crazy.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is, Paul, she might walk in the door and she might hit you with a hammer. She drove me to it. Which I would probably believe, you know.
Oh, I don't know.
It can be annoying sometimes, but he's not that bad.
I know this lassie, and I know him, and I know the other crowd, and I know them all got the scarves and the t-shirt to go with them all. But what you should do is just say, Kirsteen, if this is us now, when we go to this Isle of Man, and something big comes up, mm-hmm.
This is a wee fight, it's nothing to do with the old man. This fight was just to do with, I had 2 days off.
Mm-hmm.
We had 2 days off together. I picked the says that we'll do Saturday and I'll spend the time, I put her first. Today we're supposed to be going out today and going to Glasgow and all this sort of thing. But because she wanted the both days, one wasn't good enough, it had to be both.
But did you tell him what you were doing Monday?
Aye, he knows. We have to get the grass cut and all that sort of stuff for getting the house sorted. House sorted for what? That's what a landlord comes for. The landlord, the house is sorted. I mean, what all do we need? What do we need to do?
Put the house, and she gave in the notice?
I don't know, I think she's done that now.
She'll need to
Well, I mean, I would be seriously saying, oh, don't bother. I mean, at the end of the day, but they kind of get you out there, something you're working, you get help somehow.
I think the government
would get help somehow, and you just need to say, my crazy partner with mental issues. She's the way you look for an Isla man. She's in the hospital. Don't tell them she's done off, mind you. Oh, God, no, but this is so crazy, isn't it?
It's crazy,
probably. Yeah. And I'll tell you something, see when you started there last night and they started on me. I walked it.
I was like, and I said, I'm going to head down the road because this isn't going good. And then it's, no, don't go anywhere. It's cursing. I'm like, I'm going to sit here and just listen to it. No, I'm going. And then I picked the car keys up and I went away to go and get my bank card out of the car. And it's like, come back, my car keys, come back, my car keys. I'm like, I'm getting my bank card. You can have your car keys. I'm here to get my bank card. You give me my bank card out. She took the car keys away back. And when I was away, like, walking, ready to walk down the road, she's like, where are you going, lad? I'm away. Come back, come back, come back. Come back for what? To listen to that? No, cheerio. I'm away. And I waved. And then I don't know, I should have just thought about coming at yours, but as I said, I had to get changed. It was all my work stuff. And I just wandered right through the veil, and then that's when I got to the fountain and I could hear her beeping. Get in the car, get in the car. I got a text from my mum saying, do you want me to send Charlie out? Well, honestly, I don't know if I still got it. Do you want me to send Charlie out? And his socks and his slippers and his nightgown.
What was Charlie going to do to you?
That's another thing, cause I don't have it anymore.
Is he going to pick you up, like?
But, see, Kirsten says to me, do you want me to get my dad to speak to you? I said, get everybody, get the Queen to speak to me. I still stand my ground, because at the end of the day, I'm still spending the day with you tomorrow. And I'm spending the day with my gran and grandma on Monday. So, what's wrong with that? And my mum's like, you should be putting her first. You should be putting her first.
Does your mum really want you to be entangled with your crazy?
Oh.
Is she that desperate to get rid of you, son? Is she that desperate to get that house for the other wee lass who can't even speak to you right?
I know.
Can't say it by cursing and swearing at you?
That's why she's wanting... She wanted to give the house that I'm in to Claire, my sister. So like, it doesn't seem no matter what way, everyone's pointing to the Isle of Man. It's like,
I can't even let him out of the front door without him telling what the F are you here for. Mm-hmm. And you're going to stand there and hand you the keys to your house? Are you crazy, boy?
I know, my mum wants me to give up, when we were giving up the house, give it to my sister.
That's you, that's not up to you.
But they'll speak to the landlord about it, should they get it. That's what their plans are. Their plans are to speak to the landlord and tell her that...
You're telling me this?
No.
It's an awful... So...
I know. I just...
Dear, it gets worse.
Paul. I would just... I need to take the tablets.
Is she got your own tablets yet?
She's on the... What does she call it?
Is there anything they can have to eat, Mum? Eh?
Well,
I've no meat anything, because they're away. I just cheered myself. Macaroni and cheese or something, no? I've got a fiver one to that, so. The coffee, you can buy them, but I've not got
anything else. What was that, really? That's a basic shell, basic skeleton of it, anyway.
So now we do.
What I've said to him is, what goes on between you and his mum is getting nothing to do with him, never mind Kirsten, so why is she butting her nose in?
I don't know why her mum, I know her dad sat there, never said a word.
Did he?
No, he never said, he didn't want
it.
He didn't, because he knew fine well there was nothing to argue about. Her mum came running upstairs, and her mum's like, every second word out her mum was something like me, oh, just leave him.
I think her mum's seen this before, and her dad knows, and she's thinking this is all getting stirred up. She's thinking you're to blame for it, and maybe she's.
Remember when
maybe there's merely her and you don't know, Paul. Maybe she's been in a hospital before.
Probably. And she's driving me to one. But do you remember when I was giving up Jake? That's when her mum came round. Her mum came round then. My mum came round to saying, what's going on, Paul? I was, it's nothing to do with me. The neighbour was yelling at her and I wasn't even here. But our mum was like down at my throat. No, what have you done?
That argument you said at New Year as well.
Aye, her mum came then. Aye. Well, what was that all about?
I can't remember, but remember she packed her stuff and went away to stay. Yeah, was that? No, because she didn't want people to come over.
I wanted a new year, and I was working all Christmas, and I hadn't had a new year. She'd been away out Christmas, and I wanted a new year. I wanted a new year because I had my new year off, and it was something. And our mum came and got her, and Dad came and got her. All then
she walked away and left a delivery and everything. Because it was only me and my boyfriend that were coming on. She came out to my house quite a lot. Then she said, "What was the big deal? Just me."
That was all.
Well, she's totally fell out of us. I don't know what I've done. Yeah.
I did
the other day. Paul and that came over, and Paul had been saying he wasn't sure what he wanted today, and I'm like, well, do you want me to try and explain to her that it's not that you don't want to go and it's not that you do want to go, it's just that you don't know what you want to do? And she had an answer for everything, but at first she was kind of, why are you even saying this to me, as if she hadn't done anything wrong. She sat there and she tained it, but didn't she?
Yeah, she did.
Just saying to you after she left.
No, she said she spoke to our work colleagues about it and all that sort of stuff.
What about me speaking to her?
Yeah, I was just speaking about what was it you said? You mentioned something like you work both ways or something.
Works both ways. She's turning and saying to him, if you love me, you'll come. If he can turn and say, if you love me,
but
you'll
come. But then her work colleagues were saying, like, you're the one with the career. He doesn't have a say in the matter. That's what our work colleagues told her.
Right, yeah,
it does, I know.
So the thing is, why did she not stick up for you when your mother was running your dad doing?
That's the thing, because I says to him, I says, last night, I says, so who told you that my dad goes around, is that Kirsteen? And Kirsteen could not look me. She looked away at the telly, she looked down the flare, but could not look me straight at me, says, did Kirsteen tell you that? Well, it has to be Kirsteen, because I wouldn't come out off the street and go, by the way, do you want to hear this? It's not an interesting story.
No.
So why?
It's
And then all of a sudden she's like, I've done nothing wrong, I've done nothing wrong. It's like, you're not making matters worse, you're not making matters better, you're making it worse for me though. Why are you setting up my mum's company anyway?
I know.
When I'm not there. I understand she wants to fit in and all that, and that's all fair and square. But I'm not there. Do you know what I mean?
Anthony sits with my mum, but that's technically my mum's in my house.
Aye, well, that's different. But does Anthony go, I'm going to ring your mum's to sit?
He did when we were on holiday, he sat in her house, he preferred to have us to my house.
Did he?
When there with Rosie on the couch, eating his pizza, watching the telly.
Yeah, they're sitting in there watching telly. I'm sitting around there gabbing about goodness knows what, she knows will tick me off.
You'll need to either be a man and just say, Kirsteen, I think instead of the Isle of Man, you really need to calm down and get some help with your paranoia. To me, it just seems like, I mean, for her to turn around and say they hate you, they hate, just because we didn't come into the house that day. Now, you told us she had been a night shift. We just came back.
Yeah, I know.
We've been out a run. We comes back, and we usually just sit in the boat in the street, right at the wee car park down for his house. Now, you tell us all day Kirsteen's sleeping. She's a night shift.
The curtains are all shut.
And there'll not be any forgiveness or letting you off with it. And it's only a matter of time. And the true sides and the true colours are locking it. But she's really a silly lassie. She should just... I mean, you weren't arguing about going to Isle of Man. You've gone away in September, you've got a date, so you want to see her as much as you can. That's understandable. I would be saying to Helen, go and see your parents before you go. Go even have a holiday with them.
No.
But no. And she doesn't want that.
Well, that's what I said to him the night. If you want to just... He's what I go and do this, and he's what I go and do the next thing, and I'm like, no. Well, but we just go and we drive, we'll go and see your dad, and he's like, right, okay, we'll do that.
Well, that's... I mean, I just don't know.
Yeah, but now he's thinking, her reaction going to be to the fact that he's not here tonight?
She doesn't even know.
But then he's like, should I just let her know I'm here?
Did she phone you already?
Yeah.
But he's talking about doing a fly on Facebook so that she sees it and be like, alright, well, what's that about?
I'm not like doing
it. You know why I walk in the night and you don't get to heat the back of your hammer?
She'll not be there.
She's clipped over the limit, you know
Didn't
what I mean?
Think you'd come back though?
No,
manager will be back. She's got cats or not.
The glass cabinets are lying in the pieces.
But she's left.
I think the toys are all broke.
The telly's lying.
By the dollies.
The telly's lying.
He'd that tip him over the head, she'd be a wee crumbled mess in the flare.
The telly's a 3D puzzle instead of a 3D telly.
Oh, no.
You'd cry, wouldn't you?
I'd be great.
Awesome. Nothing worse than their home in an atmosphere.
But she's not going to be there. She's took her work clothes and all that around to her mum's because she's working tomorrow.
I'm telling you something.
I just sounded funny. Her mum even locked me out of the house. See, I was on the phone with you when I was in the garden. My mum locked me out of the house. Put locked the snib on and all that.
Are you going to get back down?
Yeah, well, Kirsten obviously came and opened it up.
Obviously, Kirsten knows what her mum's like and no one like, watched her do that, and that's why she's let you back in.
Imagine locking me at my house, snipping the snib on. She knew I was. She could see. Could see me through the pane glass.
I mean, I can imagine what it must have looked in the house, and she should say, "You took your tablets, and you took yours." Oh, son.
That's the way you can see my Christian guests if that's what her mum's like.
I know what that. I walked down.